Hey everyone, this is Mary DeMuth, and this is Pray Every Day, where I pray you through the Bible verse by verse. As I've shared with you all this month, you're probably tired of hearing it. All these verses are coming from the Seven Deadly Friendships, a book coming out in about 8 days. So be praying for that release. My prayer for that book is that it would set people free in their relationships, which is really where we all live. And some of us are battling some toxic relationships and we can't figure out why we feel uncomfortable. We can't figure out what's going on. Well, there are helpful traits and lists in that book to help you understand what kind of relationships you're up against and why they are bothering you so much. So would you just pray that that book would get in the hands of the folks who really need it? And I would so appreciate that. And again, I've asked for this already, but I'm going to ask again if you would pray for me as this book releases. There's been a lot of spiritual warfare around this book releasing, and there's a lot of insecurity inside of me. Surprise, surprise. And I would love for some protective prayer over me and over my family and over my future and all of that. So thank you in advance for doing that. Today's verse comes from 1 Peter 5, verses 8 and 9 in the NIV, and it says this: "Be alert and of sober mind. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. Resist him, standing firm in the faith, because you know that the family of believers throughout the world is undergoing the same kind of sufferings." Mind if I pray for you? Lord, so many times I think that that person who's acting like an enemy to me is the enemy, but I am reminded by Scripture time and time again that my battle is not against flesh and blood. It's not against human beings. It's against the principalities and powers of the air. It's against the enemy of my soul and all of his demonic horde out there in the world. That is where the actual battle is. And so open our eyes today to the spiritual battle around us. Instead of taking offense at someone who's hurting us, maybe help us to see what's going on behind the scenes, to see that this is actually a spiritual battle. And when I do that, Lord, I'm more able to love the people in my life who are driving me crazy, because I realize maybe, just maybe, this is a spiritual battle and not an interpersonal battle. Lord, help us to be alert, to look around, to understand that there is a battle going on. In the United States, Lord, it is not easy to see. That battle is extremely subtle. I've been in other parts of the world where it's a really overt battle. Oh, look, there's someone possessed by a demon and we're going to pray for that person. But in the U.S. and in some of those Western countries, it's hard to see the evil. It's much more hidden and inconspicuous. So Lord, help us to be alert to the schemes of the devil and help us to have a sober mind to understand this is not just a flippant thing that we do, but as we pray, we are actually a part of a battle that's going on throughout the whole world, and that there are other believers around the world suffering just as we are. So Lord, we lift up our brothers and sisters in countries where your gospel is not spreading or prevented or mitigated against, or you become, you get jailed for talking about Jesus. So Lord, would you give those folks perseverance? Would you continue to show up in people's dreams so that they meet you in that beautiful medium between awake and sleep? Lord, I see in this verse that the enemy prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. As I think of that, there's just such a, when a lion is hungry, all they do is prowl. And I know that our enemy is hungry for glory, hungry to topple down your kingdom, Lord. And so he is going to be pacing back and forth looking for someone. And so, Lord, would you protect us today from the attack of the enemy? Would you protect us and put a shield about us? Protect us from the fiery darts of the evil one, because, Lord, we are wanting to do your work, and when we do your work, we are going to get those arrows. Lord, help us to stand firm in the faith, and help us to stand upon you. And Lord, today, you know, I want to just pray for those relationships where it feels like there's no movement. It feels like the same thing is happening over and over again, and it feels like it'll never get better. And we just relinquish control in those relationships. We also ask for discernment about what is going on. And we ask that the enemy would not have a foothold in our lives in terms of bitterness and anger, and certainly not to have a foothold in our friend or family member's life. Thank you that you are victorious. You are the winner. You are the conquering king. Your name is above all names. And no weapon formed against us will prosper. We trust in that right now. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, thank you so much for listening to Pray Every Day. You are a blessing to me. I am so grateful to spend these little minutes with you. If this has really blessed you, as I shared earlier, just share it with someone who might need to be prayed for. Also, if you feel like you just want to help out to keep this podcast going all over the world, you can go to patreon.com/prayeveryday. There's different levels to support. And thank you in advance for doing that. I appreciate it. And today, be sober and alert, because there is a battle raging all around you. But don't despair, because God has the victory.